Yes. Could you add her? Okay.
Reminding the judges also to check in when you get here on the box.
Right.
Thank
you. We have to make it. Are you out?
Yes, sir.
Gotcha.
Okay. But you're using the one that was sent out, right?
I would assume so, yes.
Okay. Just want to make sure some rounds are not using their own stats.
Okay. Yeah, I'm sure that must really matter.
United States federal government should increase greenhouse gas reduction requirements on biofuel production, including from existing production facilities through a low-carbon fuel standard, depending on your life cycle greenhouse gas emissions advantage, one is foods, quote, RFS plus ethanol, juice, food, price, shocks, plants, all stone, 16 RFS, has global implication mandate for food-based biofuels by creating inflexible going to make for feedstuffs mandate, create upward pressure on price of banana, growing increase demand in price of inputs, by fertilizer and water pass on consumers, especially in developing country, food price of banana, water, food security, increase demand under my food security, driving land grabs, land development, food security, secure land, tenders, crucial to the ability, fuel processing, landing by water quality, what an impact on growing biofuel, fuel stuff, by water, spotting, community, water, biofuel production means water is unavailable for other uses as well. You lose rifles, don't include animal feedstuffs or presence, those fuels fail to develop the needs, heal from missing, saying, listen, again, for my fellow harvest, we don't do it for even more food based rifles than intended bits, kill a billion, temperature of the United States, even if merely was higher pressing report, country rampant, we quickly put food out of reach of 1.1 billion people, advantage use runoffs, nitrogen, runoffs cascade, and undermine resilience, it also causes low zone depletion fields for you, have cascade for massive rate as well, extreme acidification, eutrophication, release by diversity, healthy gene, and emission, which impact the greenhouse gas effect, and ozone effects on ozone, and profound wreaking havoc at every elevation, FX persists for decades, particularly as renewable catalyzed destruction for ozone. Water develops a dead zone that can no longer support life. The electric builds up in soil when it leaches and takes out other nutrients. It acidifies to a nitrogen disrupting the ecosystem, delicately developing, reducing, reaching active nitrogen. The amount is critical of nitrogen in the same food. Only 10% enters the human mouth. Less than a complete amount of nitrogen means a reactive nitrogen accumulated in the environment, atmosphere, groundwater, soils, and biota. That culminates in extinction design and close to extinction. The humanity is in the ability to control the nitrogen cycle with extreme rapid production growth for all these UPM, which the nitrogen cycle beyond sustainability. And O3 is resulting in increasing dead zone. N2O is considered a key GHG to mitigate. And ozone is thin. Destruction causes extinction. The Repko 16 ozone prize. Critical production, the front of the cell scorch rays, there's no ozone in the atmosphere, intensive viewers with serializing earth guide layers extremely thin farming, get a show drafting off the ozone over the continent, ozone layer to the damage where the side is good. Have a magical farm and discover the whole side is scrambled to understand the chemical process. The Antarctica is the alone in many holes on our best side, further than any of the Arctic scientists around the world, trying to depletion of ozone above Antarctica. It drives Gulf dead zone, switching to sustainable biofuels is sufficient to solve inland 16 of studies and limits indicated in bleaching excess nitrogen, major effort of a Gulf dead zone, reducing and fertilizer application temperature reduced in by 30%, which will meet maintenance and finish by the increasing nutrient. Reducing side pop oxygen to convert land to produce data, dedicated perennial cellulosic feedstock sale. Miscanthus and switches for showing how significantly lower TA and cellulose production could reduce total leach by 20% ethanol or supply. It was displaced by cellulose. Perennial biofuels solved the best studies for family. 16 previous studies for probiota evidence for ecosystem service changes to cellulose production. It is crucial in a model for emergency bound to simulate hydrolysis and miscanthus switch on cables and lazy and leaching across the basin. Introducing cellulose will decrease runoff production. The expert intended to go proportional to decrease in leaching this will lead to the efficient uptake and the results of lower leaching rates supported by numerous studies for miscanthus. Which are cellulosic feedstocks are essential to maximize the ecosystem services. Cellulosic feedstock can be more attractive for reducing the Gulf dead zone blooms cause dead zones, collapses, ocean biodiesel, spikes the oxygen. Remember, five phytoplankton play a large role in climate change. Phytoplankton influence really the climate by regulating gas in the atmosphere. Phytoplankton release oxygen as they grow. Phytoplankton die. Their water may become so oxygen poor that fish can no longer survive. The result is a dead zone extinction. Spent 96.2. Much oxygen can bring about a worldwide Holocaust experiment. Show the probability of fire increase 70%. Each 1% rise in oxygen becomes highly probable. The rise in oxygen was clearly similar to 15 stability and effective self relief measures would have prevented it. Ag emissions are the largest source of NTO. Candle 14, the global carbon cycle is affected by emissions of fossil fuels and changes in land use. So the ag plays the most significant role in NTO, increasing for less to dominant cost of emission. And NTO food is currently fossil for 90-20% of NTO GHG emissions. Climate stable to require production of CO2, CH4, and NTO. And the CO2 seems to actively remove CO2. Advanced biofuels solve they restore soil and independently sequester carbon. Candle 14 improved ag tech reduce NTO brings the adamant. No restore reversal, but an emission of permanent restoration. So it's the large potential remains kind of depleted required soil carbon cycle cover the third of the global land. Your long term permanence of carbon cycle makes fire energy trying to be good. Lie on shorter rotation. Having fish, gen biofuels of fuel emission analysis of potent GHG and oil result in highly reduced and no climate benefit. Incorporating life cycle analysis is vital. Carp 11 nitrogen fertilizer require energy manufacture result in emissions. Underscore of LCA for shows minimal reduction in the energy cropping. Only mitigating climate change. Every crop to result in blanket version food cropping mitigation effect is canceled. Out of the alternatives, only the LCA can improve change. A significant reduction could improve energy savings in GHG reduction willow. So significant improvements for nitrogen leaching, eutrophication, and acidification. Willow and poplar are highly suitable for phyto radiation. Contaminated soil today are needed for combating climate change. Mitigation adaptation, including permanent copper, less than soil. The more running costs, water carbon reduced, and diversification of land used to resilience, all can be effectively enhanced through planting perennial biomass conversion, natural habitat resulting in deforesting, a lot of biodiversity, biodiversity also being increased by planting by oil field crops. In fact, depending on what is being replaced with crops, solar studies show perennial biomass are highly beneficial, enhanced biodiversity, improving water efficiency, is important climate mitigation strategy, corn and fiber resiliency, probably increased water requirements. Water use will be the lowest for cost without high WT, perennial biomass, established roots, which withstand water shortages, long lasting can reduce groundwater, retarding ground as well as so considerable yield of further density, and is anticipated to have strong potential for improving integrated land from a freshly grown sag land, a large amount of biofuel can be reduced without decreasing food production or ag exports or approach, but reduce GHG emission by 10% of total U.S. emission between increasing soil fertility and promoting biodiversity. Multiple travels will be required, and LCFS is key, and RFS alone won't incentivize low carbon tech yet, and all 12. And LCFS is geared to put low carbon fuel tech into the market. It could build upon the RFS framework rather than requiring specific volume, it requires the regular part of media aggregate based on carbon intensity. If both RFS 2 and LCFS were replaced, RFS 2 provided volume based incentive, the LCFS could provide carbon intensity based incentive. The RFS 2 does not have the provision to align all fuels needed to meet emission reduction goals, and putting an LCFS alone or with RFS 2 could be superior to RFS 2 alone, reducing GHG emission, improving the market incentive for sensitive to lowering landing. RFS 2 and LCFS could be common battery, or LCFS could replace RFS 2. No circumvention. Our standards are based on independent science. The Fed has already given its stamp of approval to these models. We'll insert a chart. MPB 15 is part of LCFS, the border refined LCA quantified carbon intensity within 7 years, and wanted to address indicated indirect land use change conflicts among the carbon only impact of routine field. This model includes indirect impacts, making the most of a rigorous evaluation of whether to quantify the environmental footprint rankings. Findings that come with the EPA determined 5 years ago, California's analysis validated by an academic review provides confidence by reducing sustainable commercial sustainable goals, reduced GHGs are achievable estimates. Provide it include advantage 3 is forest. U.S. forest ecosystems are on the brink of catastrophic collapse from fires and disease. Milvin 16 escalating wildfires and disease ravaging America's increased effective forest ecosystems. Science predicting the amount of forest power raised by a fire will double right effect and invasive disease threat to the U.S. Forest Service are bringing point the current situation unsustainable. If we don't deal with this, the trends are going to look very bad. And we're seeing significant problems with forests. Other parts of the country ecosystems are susceptible to disease and catastrophic fire. Expansion of cellulosic ethanol solves by using forest residues as feedstocks. Polar 2K cellulosic ethanol industry forests are risk residues can all be converted into ethanol. Greater use of forest residues to address disease using excess fuel loading process. Current has many forests. That forest undergrowth has dramatically increased. The dense undergrowth creates a potential for uncontrolled wildfire dangerous spread of disease. And a cellulosic ethanol facility offers an opportunity to alleviate the threat of forest. And disease by bringing those forest settings and infrastructure to ethanol production. Cellulosic ethanol creates an economic incentive for sustainable forest management, which solves other dangers to forest health, like sprawl and industry. Lamonica 7 cellulosic ethanol promises several advantages by making ethanol from cellulose and forest recreates rather than corn produces less greenhouse gas rather than resetting biofuels production targets. Auto managed to drop between different types of biomass and use for fuels. Forests are under a lot of strain from sprawl and paper industry. Building by fuel industry around the forest is good for trees, creating the demand for tree residue. Removing the landowners have been managing resources sustainably. It's all about healthy forest. Part of that is the economic viability of owning forest land. It's key to freshwater ecosystems. FS 766% of the nation's scarce freshwater resource originating forest land. Forests can play a critical role in building paid water force provided ecosystem service and water quality overall watershed health. Forests absorb rain and snow, mainly rainwater and flows. Forests so a slow storm runoff, reducing soil erosion, improving water infiltration rates, and retard to aquifers. Forests filter pollutants such as sediments, fertilizer, pesticides from runoff forests, provide habitat and maintain aquatic diversity management, ensure sustainable ecosystem services. North American watershed diversity prevents extinction. It is unique taxonomic diversity. Walsh and a line of three has a broad way of freshwater ecosystem with a broad multiple due habitat, rich establishes residue. representing a diverse taxonomic group. So loss of biodiversity is the greatest threat impending, impending crisis facing humanity, the decline of North American fishing, perhaps other faunas that affects humankind, freshwater fish are important, sudden hills of human environmental conditions, sustainability, natural ecosystems, the balance of aquatic and terrestrial communities dependent on fish, migratory fish, and surface and keystone species of entire ecosystems. Evaluate each loss as existential, noteworthy. 14 jet, using a metaphor, dinghy, it can be seen as a block. If you take a block out, it might not fall, but it does make it weaker. Every block room increases the chance of the tower collapsing by taking away support. After a while, it doesn't take much to knock the whole thing down. After being driven close to a senior legacy, others all have seen your with the cost of disappearance of kelp, which have resulted in disappearance of the marine land. Fortunately, remnant population sea otters were discovered before it was too late. The effects of the reintroduction of the natural habitat were recovered. The removal seemingly unnecessary block enough future repercussions. Extinction will undoubtedly happen. No species stands alone, and the loss of one will always have some impact on others. Resilient ecosystems are the ones that maintain the full diversity framing contention. Major wars extinct institutions mad. Resilient economic ties and de-escalation tetras. 12, the number of potential conflict has declined. There's been no ongoing interstate war. International conflict has practically disappeared. We are living in the longest era major power crisis since the Roman Empire. Total number of wars in the world has never been so low. War has become an more intense but also less deadly. Creature of battle-related deaths radically reduced, and information civilians are the main victims of conflict has been thoroughly rebounded. The mortality due to war since 1945 has diminished. Gaddis emphasizes the structure of the international sentences between contenders and nuclear deterrence, mediation, course, tribunals, international regional organization, peacekeeping, and intervention has multiplied wars for Congress have been delegitimized. UN members have never been wiped off the map by forces formed against terrestrial aggression. Just a soundly successful trade in national economy still increases the only opportunity cost of conflict. It enhances mutual relationship, understanding, facility, negotiation, reduces strategic errors. There is a reverse correlation between number of states and risk of war. Trump prevents great power escalation, but who is 17? The president has little interest holding the burden of the global order to save the allies of groups on the own security inside of the line. The U.S. offshore balance is currently tied by a mere strong global promise. The U.S. is risking imperial overshadow for this approach. Will lead to behind the U.S. should reduce global demand. Trump's supposed to resemble a strong inclination to usher in a more relaxed great power relations. Early easier U.S. related with Beijing and Moscow. Trump's national security departments have been considered with the identification of security threats. His China policy will guide much less by realistic logic.
So in control F climate policy, it shows up 0 times in the 1AC. How does your alteration to the renewable fuel standard constitute the establishment of a climate policy?
The plan requires a decrease in emissions, which the resolution says is in a necessarily included part of the climate policy.
So the resolution says establishing domestic climate policy by at least restricting emissions. I'm confused how you're the former.
Yeah, so or why you think we're not a climate policy, first of all, because climate policy entails things like restricting emissions, changing land use requirements, promoting renewable
so
energy.
So you're a climate policy.
I mean,
yes.
We're topical.
Yes.
Awesome. Your piece of evidence about the nitrogen cycle is talking about the global nitrogen cycle, obviously. How do you solve any other country besides the United States?
Our evidence says that the United States agricultural system, largely because of ethanol, is shaping the global nitrogen cycle, and that its runoff into the Gulf is a unique global linchpin for that. And additionally, the United States' ethanol practices create global demand, which drives nitrogen cycle destruction worldwide?
Sure. The piece of evidence that says you solve this advantage is talking about how people would switch to miscanthus and switchgrass. If it's true that people switch from corn to those other things, how do you solve the food advantage?
Well, our evidence says that cellulosic fuels, when they're grown and produced, cause more soil. It reduces things like soil runoff, which is the cause of nitrogen. So when the fertilizers
are used, reduce runoff, it just runs off less, which means that people have, in order for you to solve advantage two, people have to switch from corn to switchgrass. How can you solve both advantages at the same time?
Well, I'm confused about why you don't think we can solve. Our evidence says that cellulosic fuels require less nitrogen to be produced, and they reduce soil runoff.
Okay.
Two of which
if
are driving nitrogen
cycle
in the global population.
This might be a clear answer. The cellulose that we incentivize does not trade off with food in the same way.
That's
the
my question.
Corn
people
food.
Are running off because they're using corn, and you don't trade off with food. How do you solve this advantage?
Well, ethanol requirements cause massive increases in land use for low productivity crops, which means that there's just less of a demand for that much corn
okay.
growing after the plant, which is causing
evidence
that.
Is about. The first piece of evidence on the forest advantage is about forest fires. I'm confused what cellulose does to stop forest fires.
It reduces, it uses forest residues for cellulosic fuel, which is the main cause of forest fires, as per our evidence.
Cellulosic residue is the main cause?
Well, no.
Fires?
The forest residue is the main cause,
okay.
because it's
sure.
a bunch of, like, just
the
really light material on the forest floor that ignites easily.
2007 evidence that says that cellulose solves, and the ununderlined part says, quote, deforestation should not be a concern, he says, because the state has an inventory process and, at this point, the state is growing trees faster than they consume them.
That's citing one state official that obviously has
yeah,
an incentive
the
to say that.
State
the conclusion,
that
of, our, the conclusion of our evidence is very
trees.
Obviously that these things are large threats and that we need cellulosic fuels
this
to resolve
the
them.
That says y'all solve.
Our impact isn't about one state.
Okay.
Yeah, also, that's, again, citing one person, or the evidence concludes that this is causing a lot of strain.
would be four off than framing food vegetarian force. The advantage counterplay text the United States Federal Government should ban the use of food-based ethanol for fuel in the United States, require best management practices for nitrogen-based fertilizer use in the United States, and ban fuel loading in residential dwelling and forested areas protected by the Forest Service's Plank 1 salt advantage. When the only reason that food works are carbon is because we're using our food as fuel. The counterplay bans have Plank 2 salt and nitrogen impacts. That's Roboto in 11 agriculture, single largest source of nitrogen entering the environment. Nitrogen exceeds as the greatest source of degrading air, water, and improved management, closely matches application with the needs for the ground crops, reduces excess and decreases the losses to the environment. The criteria include rate time and method only about 35% of the carbon acres receive nitrogen. Meet all three of the measurement criteria, at least 60% in need of improved management, even though improving nitrogen may boost the cost of the farmer's potential for improving the crop quality, just as well as improving farms who don't nitrogen best management practices to the conservation policy, as tradition could line up financial tangible assistance to perform best management practices more, but more needs to come to the company and comes to restriction on nitrogen threats, better alternatives to regulation, can target specific areas provided, searching for farm quality, will improve the management, is inherently flexible to take into account the farmer's resources and crop prices they are at once, it's just all Plank 3 solves, is their author's actual conclusion, Keller, in 2K, the greater use of the force residue would address a disease that excess fuel loading problems, the gear drives to many fuel loading is a condition created by the force management practices, but the resistance and conduct control to the breadth of the pump consistent in the 2 weeks with the force rise of all costs. The expansion of the rest of the principal source of the force force servers to handle wildfires. Now, the economy this side, the farmers are being fined now. The gap caused a loan crisis which devastates the global economy. Hubbard in 16, the lower shows the farmers are struggling to pay the bank notes. Still swallowed the rubber on the side of the gas loan crisis is coming in the heart of the troubles in the farm lobbies. Going for the Midwest economy, the reach around the American survey has several long-term problems and have prices effect on farmland cash flow that's spill far beyond the farm affected rule of commerce and state government spending on surrounding every sovereign limit is number one. We left our channel and long search areas lead to success. Such as the 2008 war crisis, luckily, President been rising in recent months. Global nuclear war came into the economic situation between India, China, Japan, suffered reduction in growth and research, rapidly groups of these news channels collapse, Pakistan, and extremely safe position in global cities, war between India, Pakistan, and Eastern Iran, what about the needs of proliferation nuclear terrorist attack, may lead to further dosing collapse with their cost of plans, population. Next office of politics is that healthcare won't happen now. They don't have enough votes. That's NBC in 324. The House is scheduled to vote on Friday. The most important thing after weeks of negotiations with our administration seem to be getting no closer to coming together. The necessary 250 votes are possible in the hard so wasn't enough to give itself a those like our representative makes announced that he would vote against bringing the telling measure to 32. The plan is a legislative win for Trump, which begets future ACA repeal. That's Marshall in 314. Things are looking nice for Obamacare repeal. The pressure against repealing Obamacare is working for the president. Victory begets victory. All persons are getting after his voters with a huge amount. He's not a man that's claimed to be a manufacturer. If he can manage this, it will hurt a lot. ACA repeal undermines preparedness against pandemics. Count in 16. Public health preparedness requires accidentally or someone's accidentally read as identity people and using risk of government spending on chicks. He's Obamacare price with the insurance that would not have. In other words, healthcare is absolutely critical for pandemic preparedness. Trump repeals it. We're going to hit with the deadly pandemic. The public shelter become a better deepen. The places in the church back to have access to the health of the nations that literally depends on it. Diseases cause extinction, keeping it throughout history. Plagues of Brussels due to the news black death killed half a year because of globalization. Diseases take spread. Infection global outbreaks. Diseases such as Ebola or mutated drug resistant fluid. The civilization impact is human. Previous black matter source of exposure to concern about passing future power ones and a new controlling complication. Next off is a counterplan text. The United States federal government should enact a domestic energy policy that increases greenhouse gas reduction requirements on biofuel production, including from existing production facilities, through a low carbon fuel standard accounted for lifesaving greenhouse gas emissions. It competes with the Amazon top when they lose a must have in climate as a motivation for action. Vordenberg in 11, the main motivation for climate should be the one GG releases and distribution of policies for not climate is crucial. Necessary underlying rules was motivated by environmental issues. The one implementing climate policies must serve as other issues. The leisure disputes of climate and not climate policies have the same effect in terms of GG emissions for our team for due to other reasons. Energy policy solves the Africa, stigmatizing the DOE and causing Republican backlash. Lacey in 3-7 should be just by working here. Like a service more energy could come to the climate more efficient. For markets, some of the same argument, don't let the Tea Party war fighting or facing with the Chinese over solar access. If you mention climate, they tune you out. Trump orders enthusiastic about the war natural gas, but will currently go over the government maintain the government too. Already, there's a market failure that support war for the government, war for the gene emission, DOE, so much provision, and doesn't concern about climate. But he can be the goal where he can take the country to the next clean energy company in a way to conserve Republican Party. Believe that there is a path forward. Budget cuts kill the economy and turn the F. Republicans support the F, if you stay away from climate, that's hard. In 3-2, DOE is bringing the transition clean energy to a transition supported by a vast majority of Americans. The most wrong because even those skeptical like emissions are cut. She thought of this role as the most affordable human rights for efficiency. The office of electricity efficiency renewable along with the nuclear era. Our body would also be good at the time. It cannot be worse. The transformation will limit the damage to the global economy and certainly the American economy. The cost would devastate. The way Sanders will have to making homes and factories more efficient. The world news that would have energy in the emerging energy. Internet Heart says that they will cut RBE funding. RBE is key to fuel supply flexibility. Nailer and 17 RBE threats is human for the interrelated practice. RBE the research commercialization roots of the transcript should be on the trouble line. Researchers recently went from RBE said that they're sourcing the focus to keep America safe. The military is better. Soldiers and sales are like this. Never change ultra news again. So we avoid protecting the unstable countries. Apparently, well, that might be tickets retained the funding for the Trump administration. That's key to overall readiness. Dublin 13, the protecting facilitating supply field military operations, resource intensive field defense against research tactical operations to execute mission in the complex battle specific personal instances and against hybrid threats. Solid great power war, Spencer to gain our forces, courage, defending, and defeat our forces and groups and enemies only for a less than military races, but because of the constant of the first world that the United States is not prepared to defend districts, also shall be like a last shot against the outside nations and never leave to use one high rates of the determination of reservies. Now, the framing advantage, the risk of great power war is still super high. Helen, in 16, the danger of nuclear catastrophes greater than one certainly whole world, the solid by chance of the world's supported nuclear worthy. Human service is good to be full scale nuclear change numerous other races around the world too. A break the don't these examples where accidental nuclear was not only the conclusion, say, dangerous solution because the world's budget is a more dangerous place when the US are going to bring the United States to the several regions and instances between Russian native forces and the Russians. I bring the North East to pledge the second good. I said, make the current situation build so far, but the nature's being deliberately again, not the possible term of ours and defending. Although a useful illusion of uncertainty is the last thing one wants to assume during nuclear war. The Trump evidence assumes status quo international relations, winning any dissecting means that they have changed that calculus in a way that it export. Now, the food advantage. Robust evidence includes that high food prices reduce poverty and inequality globally, and some most vulnerable populations are net food producers. While stall in 14, higher food prices reduce poverty models offer the supply reasons just that the poor benefit. We use international system of the test relation. We find robust evidence higher food prices reduce poverty. In the recent instance, the same thing accelerated the rate of global poverty reduction. The most absolutely poor are net food producers. The primary currency, a remarkably robust empirical relationship. The worst global food price spike had no negative impact on the global poor. Conclusively proves that high food prices are strongly welfare improving. That's heady in 14. The OED global food crisis has no adverse impact on the world's poor. The global poverty continues to fall. Higher domestic food prices predict the reduction of poverty. Results were robust and the holds for the term models different. Regressive different steps about the interchange of food prices and the different poverty indicators that they benefit wage increases than just by high food prices. The long run may not be very long. Now, the nitrogen advantage. There was no impact into emissions and it's offset by a reduction in methane shine in 2008. NASA's altitudes where the aircraft flies up and leaves the formation. They also both blocks and those are short lived. Days and weeks, the changes are limited to electricity close to where emissions of the greenhouse emissions are also decreased. Concentration of methane, being a longer lived greenhouse gas with the lifetime 10 years, this decreases spread over the globe. Runoff is inevitable. Growing food itself produces runoff that was cross ex, which means that the advantage is inevitable even after the outcome some sort of agricultural transition. There is no impact to the ozone. Emissions are not key. The ozone hole is not that bad. That's worthy in 14 zero hyperbole. The sea farm from movement, no favors. You do not have to dig far to find evidence that the ozone was ever nearly as interesting to be upset. That's the sun, the true station, the temperatures and winds are still driving in on the ozone hole side. How much of the damage to the ozone hole threat to? Anyway, the week is September sunshine has a part to cause a summer and hardly having a melon was to be on the rice bowl. We will live without you in the beauty that the ozone got there. The sea goes situation has been going on for 50 years. There's no nitrogen cycle impact outside of ozone. Your evidence just says that the fate of humanity is at stake with no warrants or impact explanation. Additionally, agriculture is not the primary cause of dead cells in the absence of salt. McKellen in 15 years, we optimize fertilizer use on all carbon and nutrients from simply lost the same rivers and streams carried by the Gulf Stream. Is it believe in the factors so unpredictable? Well, the fertilizer is not the only part of the problem. Three other factors are less supreme cover, artificial drainage, lawless for islands, grasslands, and parries are greater than the farm of perennial carbon, receivers, artificial damage, branded filtration, natural rivers, water, and sediments, and the transport of the streams. We need to handle different conservation and mitigation efforts by the reasons the landscape is unique attributes and challenges you can't solve globally. Johnson 15, coastal eutrophication is not just a problem. The global nitrogen and phosphorus alone is expected to double the essence are identified by economists. The more population increases, the devastation becomes more extreme, more coastal system, we become more eutrophic. It's empirically denied. There's tons of dead zones now. Born in 2008, there are hundreds of dead zones around the world that we can't really mean ecology that cut off vast areas for commercial fishing. There's no oxygen impact. Your evidence just says that it increases the risk of more forest fires. No reason those culminate in extinction. That will be answered on the forest advantage, which is where I'm going to now. Forest, cellulosic ethanol is bad. First, it destroys global biomass supplies. That's extinction. Patsick in 2008, to the extent that humans are no longer entering use, and they're due to extinction by exhausting the planetary sex of mineral soil, including water with the accelerating demand of minerals for biomass. The time scale for extinction is tricky with each of the harvest compared with the proclamation of sustainable biomass for agri fuel production. The proposal to produce ethanol for the biomass in the U.S. is more than half of the all accessible plant growth in the U.S. to produce agri fuels, which would be commendable, scale, ecological, and economic system for biblical proportions. It turned. Okay, unintended consequences cascade and wreck the environment. That's by Emilio in 2009. The addition of significant biofuel industry would create pressure on the environment through the use of land. The U.S. has mandated significant uses of biofuel, such as the policies failed to account for the unintended consequences of emissions. Trade schemes failed to increase the carbon stocks of vegetation, so as the world design policies under the global steel and carbon dioxide risk, then the biodiversity consequences of the loss of biodiversity and the cascade in consequences. This reduces terrestrial plant production. The impact is extinction. Emilio in 2009. Terrestrial primary production, the amount of MPP co-opted for the humans to produce biomass of biofuels will increase 50% of the use and co-opted MPP with the loss of biodiversity and the potential. The risk of classic petroleum uses to deliver support services where humans rely on cleansing of air water. The status quo salt deforestation globally hands in 16 Paris can point to the new air filter force, including the infrastructure serving against forest space led to support for the green plus by having multinational pay the more tropical countries to keep the forest standing $5 billion to see the problem kick off in high year. Every year, more corporations and industries are announcing zero defo pledges.
status of the planks?
Unconditional. We have to go for the whole can of planks.
You have to go. Okay.
Plans are conditional, but we can't kick
Wait.
The planks separately.
Yeah. Okay.
Sorry, just to clear that.
What's the net benefit?
Econ descending the turns off force.
Econ descend. The counterplan bans ethanol production. Why
for fuel.
What? So that obviously gets rid of the majority of the incentive for people to buy ethanol from farmers. I'm wondering how their bottom line would survive that.
I disagree with that assertion. I don't think anyone see evidence points to food-based ethanol for fuel being the thing that farmers use
what?
The most.
Okay,
for.
So what's the
like
link? What's the link
evidence.
To the farm DA then? Or the econ descend?
Well, the Hubbard evidence is about the agricultural transition that Brent was getting at the last half of cross-site. So when the app forces farmers to invest in new types of production, i.e. they have to transition away from corn, they use less corn, that creates a sort of bubble.
So the link is
well,
transitioning from corn.
Market. Well,
Hubbard is the internal link. Where do you think this says the United States economy? Because the best I've got is trouble for the Midwest economy.
Left unchecked and long-lived, such scenarios lead to catastrophes such as the 2008 mortgage crisis.
So, but... Though that's not even about the Midwest. That's just
well, so that's the conclusion of what it says after that. You're right. The first part of the card is about the Midwest because that's where the majority of farms are. But it implicates that collapse. In terms
ACA
of
won't pass because a bunch of Republicans don't support it. Which ones will switch because of the plan?
Well, you're certainly right that the NBC and the Marshall evidence don't list Republican senators by name, but the Marshall evidence is really good. It says that the way in which Trump convinces Republicans to get on board with his agenda is by getting legislative victories
so
pushed through the Senate or the House.
The Marshall evidence says that Trump needs to pass Obamacare repeal because he's a man of action. Where do you think it says that being... another victory will get it, will get repealed.
That's not at all what the card says. The line, for a president, victory begets victory. Of all President Trump's capture on his voters, a huge amount is tied up in his
claim
to be
if
a
he
man
can't
of
manage this, then it'll hurt him a lot. I'm wondering.
Well, no, he says to get the repeal to work, he needs victories. That's why the last part of the card is talking about victories, and the first part is talking about how he can get Obamacare repeal to pass.
Okay, how do we determine what motivates the plan?
Well, two things. One AC cross-ex when it was super explicit, but two, the Runberg evidence says that when we define motivations, it's based on, let's see, the motive for climate policy should be to limit GHG releases, i.e. when the app says the thing that motivates our action is to reduce GHGs from biofuel production. That creates a sort
so
of
the
stigma
link,
from
the
DOE
the
that their job
the counterplan competes off limiting greenhouse gases.
No, it competes off climate policy.
Okay, so the counterplan, what is that? Oh, yeah. The energy policy evidence says that the DOE is causing Republican backlash, and it says that a lot of, or actually not that card, the Hart Ev says that there's a DOE clean energy transition and that Republicans who are skeptical of the climate are also supporting it. Which ones would cause repeal of those programs?
All right, we'll take a little bit of pressure.
stop crap. I have 2 46 used. Well, everyone's getting that. It's going to be framing, food, nitrogen, forests, the politics this app, the energy policy counterplan, the advantage counterplan, the econ this app. There is no major power in multilateral institutions constraining aggression, deterrence, and economic ties remove the incentives. And even if they start peace, Stephen Mnuchin never actually said this had Vice President Trump analyze this offshore balancing means the great powers are less likely to escalate. The U.S. never gets drawn in an increased relation with Russia and China, which is better for great power peace. That's while holding nuclear winter is possible. Done 11 times. Change nation will overcome all megatons possible. But CO2 refraction to make it tell the U.S. is eventually voting so good it can shorten the tarnation voting wait for over 19 days. Most likely to be zero. We reduce level 1 and the retention is less than the key to extinction. The strongest possibilities favor the Ottoman, even these demand on variables like whether the war happens during the growing season, the food advantage. Their evidence doesn't assume our internal like ethanol mandate drives massive land grabs across the global south that destroy cropland and cause the loss of soil, which removes the productivity. Even if they're right about the food prices scenario, it also doesn't assume volatility, which their evidence or the magnitude of entire croplands being totally destroyed. The nitrogen advantage, nitrogen cycle disruption makes life impossible to occurs, and sign evidence is the basis of geochemical functions. Their right, and evidence doesn't make a reverse causal claim between method and nitrogen, nor is it very long or explanatory about global functioning. The evidence is from a journalist writing on rationaloffice.com, and we all know this person is paid off by fossil fuels. But our blackmore evidence on the ozone is newer. From 2016, cites a consensus of scientists, the ozone is thinner than it has ever been before and risks the irradiation of all life. But for the immediacy of this impact, yes, the plant solves runoff because root structures get longer via those to via cellulose from the plant, which means they can better store nitrogen and cascade it. In agriculture, it gets 30% of nitrogen runoff, and the Gulf of Mexico is one of the largest, most biodiverse ecosystems in the world. They have also conceded the stone evidence from the other advantage of the U.S. mandate for ethanol drives global ethanol, which means only the plant can solve agriculture is key. Yes, back to auction or back to lemnances, otherwise it risks an over-intensification of the auction cycle guaranteeing planetary extinction of the forestry advantage. Their evidence just refers to the status quo and says biofuels are occurring right now. We apply life cycle analysis mandates to solve the land trade-off warrant in the past. If our second-gen biofuels don't affect soil resilience, overwhelms it, or LL 15 MS did not alter microbial and cell level diversity away from the hydrogen from the forces to our finding support microbial disability and resilience to become the biomass recovery system relative to the traditional system. The dual purpose SGs has rising encouraging alternative to science when they say plant biomass production. His assumption on inputs or outliers, much more credible studies, is through camera slug, six passing results saying that is never magnitude than the other studies. The reason is passing assume that energy is generated by fossil consumption rather than lynching a world of a model generate, but lynching the other three teams are highly credible. The report supported by USDOE is one of the most durable and transparent analyses ever conducted. Fossil energy inputs second for less than energy value of surplus electricity delivered, indicating an excellent return of renewable electric energy under non-renewable energy in massive rejected streaming solution. He is fine as a researcher 10 years ago signed that passing the American Indian says senior agriculture economist of my steps and clarity the court offers to us nation for unorthodox assumptions don't come close to meeting the standards of the standards that so they don't meet the standards of transparency. They do not clearly state additionally the forestry stuff. Their evidence is just about global trends. Our evidence says U.S. forests are about to collapse because of fires, but only the plant can incentivize sustainable management. Cellulosic ethanol is key because it creates an incentive for management color to gain a larger sum of culture is in the lunch and forest. Sensor to ensure forest health reduce risk. If we have strong fire, we're linking forest health to greenhouse gas reduction. The muscle weakness to run to work for for forest health management, so it looks like ethanol special unified methods of the forest health that is key sustainable management and have a timely diverse number of so our kids for the full spectrum of what you master care of forest produces important fair so sustainable forest management as in their absence markets may not take place at all and seems to be left over so let's go with the wild forest insects and diseases. The Affordable Care Act is absolutely preposterous. You have read no evidence the plan is a win for Trump or even that Trump would support it. It's not an opportunity cost of rational policy to the plan and maintain Trump care. They have no internal link to global diseases. Additionally, burn out check signer of NDT, 14 block risk to quotes a low property model suggests for the flu that kills 1/3 of population occur once every 10,000 years. It's these tests like 1,000 ecosystems, 2 billion spread selection pressure, breaks in incentive, first relational infectivity, and 1,000 uniqueness overwhelms the link and multiple thumpers. Trump care will inevitably fail. Russia wiretaps healthcare courses and low approval means he can't get a win win. 320 Trump is running out, political capital, the worst time. Trump's rule will hit units line of cause the tree with scandals, Russian increase, and Andrea office, well, the leading the press logic, but they're not coming to worst time is he successfully performing. But Russian votes climate, so don't know what we can be in for boards, such as rules are for like 15% of the worst. As a homie says, Moses generates fresh headlines with connection to Russia, Trump's own public area could be dangerous, like these, which do have all rights, those through globalized security moderates and certain facilities simultaneously also through major issues, such as the political capital, joining political capital now, the energy pick, permutation to both, permutation to the plan through the process of the counterplan, and permutation to the counterplan. Climate policy is government mandate to reduce emissions, France and 13, climate policy for direction by government to accelerate measures to curb GHG emissions, and also through government, also fuel taxes, evitrating energy incentives, efficiency standards, and land use policies. Their interpretation makes climate policy a question of intent, which is impossible to falsify and ensures by an infinite number of random picks that avoid politics that obfuscate core debates. It's a reason to reject the team to deter this. They have not. They also make combination based on the resolution, not the plan, which deters the incentive for strategic plan text writing. It also causes a run to affirmative vagueness. We should be held accountable for what we have specified, not a word that we didn't use. No link. They have no reason the GOP perceives the plan as a climate policy in the same way as Paris or what their evidence describes. Their evidence just says the GOP would not like the idea of people talking about climate policy. It doesn't say that they would backlash and arbitrarily cut a program that their evidence says they like right now because it's good for the military, which disproves the politics link as well. They have read zero causal link on this question. They have no reason this laser is defeated, this system is defeated the entirety of the military. Hedge is unsustainable. It doesn't solve the 14 American hours into plan. The culmination of the crisis long press with the great recession slowly tries to magnify their impact with one balance of payments, deficits, and federal budget deficits, and the real crunch will pay the early 2020 fiscal and actors are to make work practice of dollars to vulnerable defense, significant to under appreciated restraints upon predominance pressure to reduce military spending is likely to increase the size of the federal budget weighted attempting target for China's post to displace through China US or collision course. Fast decline is better as first peak solar retraction, slightly back to 11. The retraction of the most common results of the plan, the faster risk tolls, the more drastic retraction policy, and the more likely it is renounced risky commitments, cut military spending, and avoid dissent. The action abuse mark the card at the word disputes, the advantage counter plan, permutation do the plan and the process of the first plank of the counter plan, which bans ethanol from corn production. That is something the plan does by applying life cycle standards. They've said they can't kick planks, which means that this is just plan plus and they can't go for this. They have not explained how it avoids any of the disadvantages. It links the economy disadvantage because it requires the end all the corn ethanol that their evidence says is key. It doesn't solve forest fires because their evidence doesn't say the government has the capacity to do this management. It also doesn't incentivize any sort of sustainable management that only tying economics of cellulose to forest fires are able to do. Federal management is a bureaucratic nightmare and causes more wildfires over the aggregate and five federal land literally capture on wildfires and increasing closures. This management of forests by the U.S. Forest Service and PLM went to also question exceeds the budget amount the USF has is forced to relocate funds for other programs so as fire borrowing this year's fire season to cripple again to the federal West Management has a frivolous allegation attempt to keep peace with extremist government hammering the most natural and cost-effective wildfire prevention techniques and put rural communities at risk condition as voting issues use the 2AC that's not access to office and causes and the arc of clash encourages sophistry over accuracy which undermines debate's political value. Our counter-interpretation is dispositionality which is the only reasonable limit that nitrogen plants do not solve. Your evidence doesn't say the federal government has the capacity to do this. It also maintains the largest source of nitrogen runoff, which is unsustainable agricultural practice. It is not just ethanol, but other things. It only switched to cellulose. It's able to have the root structures grow enough to absorb that, which stops runoff. The economy is at. They have no evidence. The Midwest is key to the entirety of our economy. That's what you get for voting for Trump. High food prices are being returned like, yeah, I love it. Rising prices are hard to pull back. And unwise voting, rising food prices are reducing super default on price. Rising prices once on high inflation, hobby, and social price. Rising food prices, high prices affect growth in the world's fastest growing economies, such as China and India. Additionally, magnifiers are a bigger control link to hits of 15. America was lucky. Well, for any truck, so Palm Valley or Denver, California faced on price and fire behavior. The worst is yet to come with the lightning or an arson to match the fire next time. We're back to San Jose, San Diego, or LA, each time a major international company will be from wildfire quotes in Central California, literally burn up. And EPA mandate right now increases a huge hole in global demand, filled by palm oil, Martin 16 UK, as frozen increased 100 million gallons to the industry as a more bullish view
growth rates is far in excess of domestic resources. Oil don't need to be reliant on imports of biomass oil. Would create a huge oil and a huge hole in the global natural oil market. Would dollars be filled by formal expansion of the EPA should scale back its proposal to light up these constraints. That drives will lock up pirates. One file 16 will lock in Singapore source global shipping superhighway cyclones. Source like place to be since source source heat. Higher sequence of local air crude oil palm oil and small oil production to grow. So this engage of pirates then takes the right upon religion. Indonesian syndicate 12 oil started moving up collapse of the global economy and great power men and one. The major traits are credible to the global economy. Lock up by far most important parties to the energy of Japan, China. So if it would suffer severely from the law passage, fragmentation of electric delay, maritime traffic movement, Japan, which affects the insurance rates, would rise coverage fee. Now you had some structured energy market, machinery, manufactured goods, would register from capital markets, investors, we see it all flow. FDI would flow. The plan creates new resources for rural economies. That is the 1AC NAP evidence, which overwhelms the link. The link of the disaster cure that NAP comments in 14 to the last 3 years, more than half all banks have closed in rural areas. These figures are due to the default digital technological advances, lack of session planning, and increased regulation of all the bank closure nearly 96% of the community banks. The 42 aside by being the lending has decreased into rural banks. Have fewer traditional institutions, more evidence, Edelman, 16 for decades, community banks have been declining, declining, previous longer. No price, there are many reasons, including slow development, growth of rural areas.
Take a second, brother.
Share a moment. Do you want to share a moment?
What's up?
Oh my gosh.
No, but you don't need it.
Yeah, I can I'll start. I'll start.
I saw this myself.
Okay, 934.
Great.
Yeah.
Did you get
it? Want to start with the Malacca turn. The minute evidence says that you've creatively highlighted the major streets. It's the three major streets is what the card is talking about. Why do you think the clash of Malacca means that there are no other avenues for trade?
Sure. Well, if you look to the next line in the Mandate Evidence, which we have highlighted, not too creatively, does indicate Malacca is key to the energy supply of South Korea and Japan,
right,
which are
the
countries that would be going
into
this.
Right.
Evidence
says there are two other straits that we use for global trade. Why don't we use them if Malacca is taking over
Malacca? How would China get their oil if the Strait of Malacca shuts down? Just geographically, it initially goes through Hormuz, and then to actually get it over to China, it has to go through Malacca.
Okay, that all makes sense.
You can't get it directly from Hormuz straight over to China.
Move on. This evidence that says it's key to the sophistication of Malaccan pirates, when do you think either evidence says that the sophistication of Malaccan pirates means that the Malaccan Strait can no longer be used?
Well, the threats to the Malacca Strait are the pirates. And as they get a lot more revenue, which palm oil demand is the largest driver for, that makes them better able to hijack ships.
That's fine. Let's talk about
I mean, we're
going to
read a lot more cards in
the
1 hour on this question, but I think this evidence lays the basis.
The 2AC has made the arg that Trump is transitioning to offshore balancing now. The 1NC said that we need to have naval readiness, i.e. naval ships need the ability to have batteries to sustain their operations. Why do you think Hedgebat is offense for you?
Because your Spence evidence on the terminal impact level is written in a 2000 Heritage report that describes the need for a robust forward presence.
Well, it's actually about
that's
the need to respond to hotspot escalations, which isn't
our
balancing, so offense because...
Well, because that hotspot escalation is what angers Russia and China, that our 1AC evidence says is what undermines relations.
Well, you made the argument
if
the transition
look,
would be to offshore balancing,
well, Trump's
which still necessitates hotspot intervention.
Form of offshore balancing does not entail those sorts of interventions, and that's demonstrated by his criticisms of Libya, etc.
Well, okay,
like,
I agree with you that your author's indicts of offshore balancing might be different, but your arguments about why Trump is shifting to a different offshore balancing regime, where do you think your evidence says Trump's offshore balancing regime would be one that agrees with Lane? Because that seems preposterous.
One that, well, I mean, the Trump offshore balancing arc is a scenario for, like, global wars won't escalate because the U.S. won't get involved, right? The other argument that
so
it makes...
then what's your arg for we just intervene everywhere causing impact to hedge back, not just
if
we
you
have selective
can, if you can see
you're
no
in the
war,
that says
if you concede no war, there is no impact.
Well, we don't have to concede no war because your evidence says we wouldn't intervene, which is fine. The first straight turn...
I mean, you can
read,
try
the megafires destroy the economy evidence. The Dickens evidence is about... like mass wildfires that could hit, is it Metropolis? No, it's literally just
Silicon Valley or Denver or San Diego or LA.
Right, this evidence is about when, like, just an unanticipated wildfire happens, like, from natural causes. How does the app solve that?
The app solves those natural causes for two reasons. One, the main driver of those forest fires is a buildup of forest debris, which the plan creates an incentive to convert into cellulose.
It doesn't
stop the plan and
the forest causes
the
megafire, which is what this evidence is about.
That is what causes the megafire, and the 1AC evidence is fantastic on that.
You don't stop lightning.
Okay, 934.
It's hard to stop.
You got us there.
just sent the second one.
Yeah, I got it.
Okay.
No, no, just type that up.
Moving a little slow here.
Economic collapse causes extinction, great civil unrest, and cloud collapses traditional avenues for cooperation, causes conflict never reaching the goal of terrorism, increases the propensity for miscalculation, which subverts their generic defense, takes out all other wars, but war doesn't happen, always on time frame, immediate economic collapse causes explosion, violent conflict, you can only die once on the app, causes a bottoming out of demand for corn because they eliminate the demand for ethanol biofuels, which means that the prices for food collapses, means that the people sell off their bank loans, demand for corn and ethanol is uniquely key to land values, the app shifts to RIMFED and RIMFED 2016, today's agriculture sector benefits from the mandate of corn to the RFS, shifted the demand for the curve, resulting in higher prices for the commodities, the strong support for the farmland, values of farmland, values of the ethanol production, the corn, the strongly correlated to the industry will continue to be a major driver. The community banks are foundational to the U.S. economy. It's key to overall stability. Blanket chip 2008 to morale, now free to market business concern about the need of capital credit, despite the immediate coverage of the credit cards. The community bank leaders are a key source of financial services to small business, the most prolific job creating sector of our economy. The community banks and the building blocks of the bottom of small business capital credit, the all reasons in the country, they play a vital role in the growth of the easy leads of the 50 states of rural America is key. That's firm in 2014. The rural America contributes to growth, building, competitiveness. The agriculture sector has been at the forefront of this recovery. Agriculture extends far beyond the business sector, became closely introduced in 2012. Output contributed $167 billion of our GDP. The overall contribution has been the multiples of the ag sector. Listen, the economy, the agriculture market is a contribution to the balance sheet. The agriculture production supports the energy sector. The industry supports one of every 12 jobs. They say higher prices are bigger internally to the economy. We'll win this debate on case they have terrible evidence on the question of higher prices. This card doesn't say collapses the economy. It says that prices affect growth. Avi.gov, that's how the economy works. They say they create new resources. The impact defense of Malacca will be in the one hour, but there are two other states already saw that impact. It's not key to the economy. Our internal link definitely outweighs all their empirical evidence. Doesn't answer the war in our evidence. The internal link is large enough to cause a bigger collapse than the 2008 mortgage crisis. Our evidence says that the rural America has been heading up the recovery past 2008, which means that even in the past, if agricultural collapse didn't cause a collapse of the economy, now is key because it's at the forefront of our recovery. It's at the forefront of the recovery, not the counterplan. I'm not going for a concede. The permutation just tests competition conditionality. We get two of them. Prefer it. First is key to negative flexibility. Congress key to check the negative strategy. Their interpretation position hold us key to check inherent outside bias. Second is ideological extremism. Testing the app from both sides. Force them to defend the map, not their ideology. Fosters in U.S. decision making. Most decision on yes, no, but find the best balance. Third is AF burden. We must test a critical policy. Yes, with the plan that both ground the 1AC makes it predictable. Having a defense of restricting emissions solves our offense. Fourth is info processing. 2AC processes decision on which arguments. Having a defensive climate policy solves your offense. Fourth is info processing. 2C presses decision on which arguments are critical to developing the affirmative rule. Critical thinking which solves your education claims. Fifth is no contradictions. Conceding double turn takes out negative offense. We don't link to their offense. We didn't cross by six. Excuse inevitable. DAK contradiction. Perm T violation solving child debates inevitable. Seventh is logic. The status quo should always be an option. Eighth is reject the argument. Not the team. The judge is referee. If we haven't made the debate unmanageable, then don't vote us down. The framing contention. Massive risk of great power war, but none of their evidence assumes either the DA scenarios, which are about the collapse of the economy or the collapse of the U.S. economy, breaks down the traditional avenues of cooperation, which they list like multilateral institutions. Those go away in a world without the economy. Recent uptick in tensions, rising powers, more nuclear weapons equals a propensity for accidental war. That's our 1 in C evidence. We said the same thing after World War I, and guess what? World War II happened. This is not a drill. The risk of nuclear war is very high. Lived into the 2016 fire alarm. There is no drill. We spoke of the nuclear war. This is our effort to put the fire alarm. Nuclear war could be close to war situations. You sure it is special. Last 4 years, fresh time goes unpredictably led the increased military. Minded Russia leaders have nuclear threats, India material rallies with the Pakistanian use subsequently purposes. Into the culture of the military is developing rapidly nuclear technology and indirect threats from the United States and China-U.S. relations increase intensely. The pressure of the South China Sea, Israel, left the MPP, the Israel would employ the massive retaliation to protect the terrorist organization by the steel nuclear weapons. The United States would employ the nuclear 12 new submarines, 100 strategic bombs, a new generation of gravity bombs, and nuclear war, etc. It's a hacking computer glitches, fails countries to choose a predicament, ego-driven racial fear, nationalism, religious extremism, may lead leaders who are unstable. Trump's offshore balancing doesn't solve arguments. A lot of this would be on the hedge now since the one our nuclear war caused extinction from nuclear winter bomb 2015. The nuclear war would likely result in nuclear winter nuclear explosion sent in the past, close the stratosphere, which caused global problem. The problem is conflict. Can ensure that every country, no matter where war occurred, this bomb could be at stake. The forest's advantage, cellulosic ethanol, collapses forest, causes extinction, collapses terrestrial biomass. Excuse me. He has conceded both of the Malillo cards. They are out of constructives. That piece of evidence says that they were erect terrestrial capacity. Turns their forestry scenario. Cellulosic ethanol cannot solve the advantages without using 50% of available net primary productivity. That's the second Malillo card. It's the only piece of evidence that quantifies how much biofuels are necessary to feed the United States demand. Even if they do a life cycle analysis, we just use too much of the damn forest in order to solve their advantages. They've also conceded the unintended consequences argument. Forest management causes cascades of environmental problems which can't be foreseen, which a life cycle analysis doesn't solve. Now the soil argument, yes, cellulosic ethanol destroys soil, composes that collapses all food production and ensures extinction. Acre 2008, cellulosic ethanol would have to leave the waste as a bioenergy crop residues, not waste from the ecological perspective. Bioenergy represents a pyramid of critical layers foundational to the decomposers, living the energy in the waste. As the waste returns to decomposes the energy, some composes except for biofuels, the food waste returns to decomposes the food with the soil composes the energy may represent even more serious threat to the humanity. This depleting
an impossible entry if we start composites. We have to provide future humanity with our only source of biological energy. Also causes peak phosphorus. So a fill pot 2008 consumption of phosphate rocket increased due to demand for biomass in the biofuel production farms are harvesting large yards of plant rubble and natural sources of phosphate. Return back to the soil. The loss of natural fertilizer means more P and K demand for future ancestors. Cellulose and ethanol, which utilizes whole plants, will need more phosphorus as demand for the finite resources will grow an even faster clip that causes extinction. Energy bulletin 2007. Phosphorus is now necessary for life. Phosphorus is one of the three major nutrients considered for plant growth. Future generations ultimately face with problems of obtaining enough to exist. Phosphorus is one of the limiting nutrients in the natural ecosystem. Supply of available phosphorus limits the size of the phosphate possible. The next two arguments are only indexed to PASIC. We have authors other than PASIC. The Melillo evidence says analysis of the net primary material productivity that's available and how much would be necessary if we transition to cellulosic biofuel says they use 50% of it causes the unintended consequence that the evidence says it's so bad causing collapse of the biosphere. The last argument about forest management revitalized ethanol entry the results in genetically engineered low lignin trees. GFC 2008, the ethanol industry is heavily primitive fuel with woody resources. This will have dangerous impact about adversely profile the manufacturing trees with the trees enhance useful feedback stocks of cellulosic ethanol has serious ramifications for global biological diversity. New demand for wood will accelerate the deforestation all over the world with serious consequences. Causes global forest depletion. GFC 2008 study should underscore the likelihood of contamination of native forest for planting. GE trees manipulated to facilitate the agriculture. The consequences could be severe, irreversible, fast growing seedling death. Stage could get the evolutionary advantage over non modified resources. Trees modify the resistance to fight disease. So likely fresh epidemics of fungicide may be dangerous to soil ecology through the ability of trees to take on nutrients potentially newly recommended viruses to come to wild plants is a very serious extinction. NRDC 2007 forest ecosystems are critical to maintain life on the forest. The oxygen filter, the pollutants and stabilizing climate, healthy forests are critical to the web of life.
The question. Oh, actually, I'm going to do a little bit more.
Status quo solves deforestation. The last piece of evidence, yes, is about global deforestation. Also, takes into account the United States. Even if it doesn't take into account the United States, the fact that every other forest in the world is still existing means that there's some sort of resiliency. Here is more data. The status quo solves web 2016. The progress is made on track in deforestation and corporate supply chains. We must recognize the progress made. The forest trends and the data reflects that progress. Now the nitrogen advantage. First, you can't solve advantage two because you write advantage one. Runoff comes from growing corn. Their evidence says cellulose causes solves runoff because it isn't corn and switchgrass runs off less. Their argument on advantage one is that the U.S. farming practices don't change. I.e., we grow the same amount of corn, which means that farmers use the same fertilizers and the same runoff happens. We just don't use that corn for fuel. The emissions, or one and C number two, there's no impact to nitrogen. The shine evidence says that NOx increases the ozone compounds and decreases the methane. He's not paid off. He's citing other studies. The emissions that ruin the ozone also solve it. Ring 2009, the ozone doesn't protect us from anything. The sun rays hit us at the same time they hit the ozone. Protection could be possible if we make everything below molecule ozone disappear. Topic during the UV, rather the light reaching the earth. CFCs are on the break. The pool very stable. Uncreated. The researchers come to the UV light, break down the CFCs, releasing the chlorine, which does not damage. If it could happen, the ozone will get replaced by CFC liquid to protect us. The other CFCs, the runoff, the incident, the ozone, the effect of 1 in 1,000, the 100,000, the image to train the chlorine reaction would go observed. UV protect us. There's no evidence of chain reaction would occur. The Ridley evidence cites the NASA study says the temperature and winds alter the ozone, which proves all causes or no impact to these arguments. There are multiple all causes to nitrogen runoff besides agriculture, the loss of perennial cover, artificial damage, the loss of the wetlands. That's our McLellan evidence. The affirmative doesn't solve these things. Global dead zones definitely take out the impact, even if they change the way that people do their agricultural practices. Our Johnson evidence disproves. The U.S. Key Warden says that coastal eutrophication is happening from a global increase in urbanization, not farming practices, which proves an all-cause that the affirmative modeling claim cannot capture. The Bornstein evidence also indicates that there are hundreds of dead zones that already exist globally, which means that they cannot solve the impact of this advantage, the food advantage. High food prices are good. They save billions of lives. We want to see Warsaw evidence as a long-run economic analysis of past food price shocks and finds that spikes massively increase revenue for the world's poor. The long-run analysis key because of the massive supply adjustments that happen in response to spikes prefer evidence that temperature being is only speaking to importing countries. Our evidence indicates that most of the world's poor are net food producers. Massively benefits from higher prices. 08 disproves their impact. Massive spikes, but poverty continued to decrease. Hedy uses a variety of models for analyzing the relationship between prices and global hunger. The result holds for different models, different regressors, different assumptions about the endogeneity of foods, and different poverty indicators. Food-related instability takes form of protests and riots, not land grabs, which solves the risk of violence and war. That's Bard et al. 2013 food riots have proved the extremely disruptive and threatening the government, but not to have violent, all the instabilities, bad, destructive political conflict, occur popular, the large-scale conflicts, and global mobilization against state policies, giving forces, productive chain, we make forces to state to adopt policies that enhance food security and stability by offering redress for structural grievances that otherwise lead to what greatest dangers combined from the protest but from interstate war.
That was kind of interstate war.
You good? Let's talk about this GMO trees argument. Your evidence says, quote, trees with lignin have to be engineered with additional trait for diseases and insect resistance, which leads to concerns should these genes escape. What is the likelihood of those genes actually escaping if these forests are heavily controlled and kind of regulated by GMO?
I would say the concession of the Melillo evidence means that your heavily controlled and regulated arguments aren't that true, right? The unintended consequences that happen when anybody who wants to supply cellulose to the market, if they get to plant their own GE trees, then those risks become
okay.
highly likely.
So the risks come from, like, anybody, as you said, being able to plant these GE trees, right?
Just come from GE trees in general, because GE trees contain the genes that can shut down the
All right, that's interesting, because the GFC card right before this one says, quote, there is a rising emphasis on use of cellulosic feedstocks to produce ethanol, and then right after that is the beginning of your highlighting about that causing GM trees. If you're right that any planting causes these catastrophic diseases that destroy all of forests, why isn't your internal link inevitable? Because of current cellulose.
So you can concede that squirrel solves cellulose puts you in some trouble.
No, but it doesn't have enough to solve
our
advantages, but you said any
cellulose
causes these GM diseases.
Right, I say the planting of GE trees releases the genes into the forest. Obviously, there's a linear risk. The more that we commercialize cellulosic ethanol, the more of those bad trees get planted, higher risk that the forest gets shut down.
Ah, a linear risk,
right?
I see.
People
Your
are tampering
field
cellulose
evidence about peak phosphorus is
it.
Not citing anybody, and it is a food editor at Grist. What is that?
I'm not sure what Grist is.
Grist with a G.
Grist. I'm not sure what Grist is.
All right, cool. The best line in this card just indicates that it creates more use of phosphorus. Where do you think it even says that it causes peak phosphorus, which your impact evidence is about?
Sure. So the Philpott evidence says that the decrease in natural fertilizers that result from cellulosic ethanol, i.e. how you solve your runoff advantage, necessitates an increase in demand for phosphorus.
Yeah, but why is that enough to overstretch global supplies
so
to the point that
humans
can't
survive? So if
our
argument is right,
that
you use up 50% of net primary productivity, that means you're covering a lot of the United States with the cellulosic ethanol, which means a lot of demand for phosphorus.
All right, that's an interesting spin. I'd like to talk
about
the economy this out. Your Blankenship evidence is from the vice chairman and COO of a community bank, talking about why community banks are important
right.
for the economy.
He's talking about all
why
the
is it this individual
community bias? Banks have done to promote economic growth in the wake of the recovery.
All right, where does this evidence?
Not
so your internal link though is just about rural banks. This evidence is about any sort of community bank anywhere. Why doesn't this demonstrate that many community banks are not impacted by the F?
A lot of the community banks, for example, that are firm in evidence or are 1NC evidence says is necessary are in the Midwest. Like rural
so you'll ask the judges to look to the 1NC Furman card on this is key to hold.
No, the 2NC Furman card or the 1NC, forgot the name.
Okay,
either
cool.
one of them says it.
I mean, the econ disad, just for the purposes of keeping people's flows the one lead, it's just the Malacca turn on the econ DA, then the politics DA and the energy policy counterpoint.
Economy disad, the largest likelihood of the global economy and it's resilient to those scary pirates. Glacier and 13 few sustained all disruptions would be longer and longer prolonged than the use of the strategic political reserve and coordination with other currents replacing all loss or at least two reserve for the offsetting of the massive cut off of oil for being much greater than moderate pressing increase in direction of GDP. The probably is low cost will lie within the reach of the expected cost for major oil disruption. Politics aside, not going forward, can see that the F's not a win for Trump, which proves our DOE cutting arguments, which we explained on the energy counterplan. Also, can see the impact defense and risk of affirmative offense. Energy counterplan. Two framing arguments at the top of the counterplan. First is that the counterplan decisively solves all the case implements the F's restriction that's in the energy policy. They don't have an offensive reason for being a climate policy. This is the damn climate policy topic, and they don't have a defense of that. They want to see there's no solvency of which means a risk of a net benefit justifies a negative amount. The second is the conceded DOE funding scenario. No new one-year arguments because block strategy is predicated on twisty miscues. The DOE is fighting for funding among Trump's widespread funding slash as crucial clean tech programs like ARPA-E can justify themselves if and only if the DOE is able to successfully distance itself from climate discussions. They're doing so by framing the debate around jobs, competitiveness, innovation, but the F's climate policy reframes that debate back towards climate change, which is the death knell for the DOE, which collapses the foundation of the modern economy, which is the hard evidence. We solve all of their straight turns to the economy disad via the counterplan, but are the only team that accesses this external DOE funding cut scenario for economic collapse via the counterplan. First argument is Prim Dubol that links to the net benefit. The one the evidence makes this super duper clear. If you mention climate change, Republicans backlash. Energy efficiency policies that are justified in any other ways do not draw backlash. The app must defend climate as motivation for the actions of the permutation links. The counterplan doesn't shield their arguments. Our argument isn't that the energy overwhelms the unpopularity of climate, but rather that climate is such a toxic buzzword that there's only a risk that including it causes a backlash. The next argument is permutation should be in the process of the catalytic ban that begins a question of, or begs a question of the composition of rather if we want the catalytic function to be better, the permutation is severance rejected because it allows the after skirt negative ground and makes being makes establishing negative strategy impossible. Permutate the counterplan. Permutation to the counterplan debate. Whoa, here we go. The function of the policy is determined by both the implementation details and how it is framed. The affirmative has to defend that their after skirt is a common policy on the floor of Congress and to the public after it's enacted. A few arguments. First is that it's relevant in the literature. There's an intent to compare specificity. We're the only ones that have evidence that draws a distinction between climate and non-climate policies. Merely what a climate policy can include. Prefer the specificity of the one to see evidence. Japan proves our argument. The distinction is relevant. That's Runenberg in 2011. This has been demonstrated by the virtual stabilization Japanese energy relates to emissions from 1973 to 1986 prior to the introduction of an expensive express Japanese climate change policy. Second is that current U.S. political climate demonstrates our argument. The one to see Lacey evidence makes it very clear that there are profound differences between having a course of action framed around climate and one that is not. It affects elections, political capital, budget debates, etc. The additional links prove that this is true as well. There's also a follow-on argument. It's the point whether or not we use the framework of climate policy influences how others react in the future, which proves functional competition. The type of policy plays on specific political contexts that alter their course of implementation. That is Rotenberg in 11. The policy happens while from the objectives of the policy's feedback to effects on the detectable circumstances for new policy decisions. A policy intervention may be independent from the behavior and outcome of the political context. Aims to create many coalitions, aligning interests and actually successful competition. While measures start to fulfill the interests of the larger system of the larger coalition, given while decision of capital policies for climate policies are critical for understanding what the underlying motives are behind in action when it's presented as climate policy, but it serves other interests. Decisions are relevant to perceive what the emissions reductions might be taken with a further justifications. Beast one is EPA justifications. A plan would force Trump to allow the EPA to tackle the subject matter of climate change. And this is reversal. The EPA website proves Volage in 17 Trump issues restricted the EPA to remove the climate change alarm. From the website, the latest move to erase the climate change initiatives. Finally, said the EU proves that it aims to find policy in the context of climate. That's, oh wow, that's a weird name. Worsakak in 14, the climate policy is a tool aimed at meeting the fundamental goals reducing greenhouse gas emissions. Now, our interpretation is better for debate, which answers the theory pressed in the 2AC. First, is necessary to check fringe affirmative. There are thousands of industry and pollutants of the week staff. We all know the arbitrariness of substantial, which forces the app not to run from the topic at the end of the year. Second, it checks mechanism explosion by forcing the affirmative to defend what the topic said they should, i.e., the establishment of a climate policy. Third, is that defending climate leadership is not hard for the athlete could read as offense for the catapult. And fourth, is that it rewards innovation, and the alternatives are certainly worse. The 2AC cross-ex said, yes, we are a climate policy, we are topical, which demonstrates that all their theoretical precedents should be disregarded given how they answered the competition question. Bernas and 1AC cross-ex now vote against it for the reasons above. First, is that the permutation is severed without a stable affirmative debate and becomes impossible. Second, this topic how the affirmative has to defend the words of the resolution. Resolve means to remain firm. If they can perm do the catapult without suffering, this means that they were never a climate policy to begin with, because climate policy is the core of the resolution of the topic debate as defined by our functional competition arguments above. Now, the theory arguments that are in counterinterpretation for the theory argument, i.e. the ones that we shouldn't get these random picks, is that we should have textually and functionally competitive counterplans, or rather functionally competitive counterplans. First, our offensive forces education, all of our offensive above demonstrates that the heart of the climate change debate is whether or not you use climate as motivation for action. Second, is our defense. We don't justify random picks. We force you to defend that the motivation for your action is climate policy, which demonstrates that all of my offensive above is impact terms of their theory of impact terms of their theory argument. Their counter definition of climate policy is necessary but not sufficient. It says that it has to include emissions reductions, but our 1AC evidence says that you have to justify your policy via climate. The argument about the competition on the plaintext at the rest was also answered above. 1AC cross-ex granted us competition for the counterplan. The next argument is that there's no reason the GOP perceives the cuts. Our evidence does not say the GOP likes the program now, but rather the GOP does not target the program because they don't think it has to do with climate change. The AF changes that calculus. That was the overview above the hegemony terms. First, this is an offense for them. This was all in cross-ex. Offshore bouncing necessitates a strong naval force. You can see the 1AC neither evidence that the sustainability of the Navy depends on the development of new batteries, which the counterplan is key to. You also haven't read defense of readiness in the 2AC, which means that this is not an offense for them. Even if attrition is good, it doesn't disprove the efficacy of a ready military, which means that we solve the terminal impact of the terms anyway because you don't have offense. Additionally, the perception of hegemony is inevitable, which means that the term doesn't matter. Dresser and some of the world seems to treat Americans as hegemonic in a pair of six or really essential future non-Americans. Do they always doubt the immediately invent 6% of the U.S. Army terms made modest difficulty and policy is more difficult. Additionally, is your studies are wrong, retrenchment is worse. Thompson and 12, McDonald pair make debate about such the producer misleading finds excuse that behaviors all repairs is equally trained all questions clad all hydrogen strikes and that's more about the future of the database is worse panics around it. Rocks that it would be impossible to know whether the U.S. China transition or U.S. relative climate were likely to become influential or peaceful. Lane is also flawed. Wolf 4 and 12 Lane deals with lack of analytical consistency. This consistency is skewed towards the recent events of indicating Lane's link between the production derives from the unreflexive or unreflective rather. So that is marked it. That's a Wolf 4 credit, unreflective.
Yeah.
of 7 cases was a conceded argument throughout the entirety of the debate. They do not have a single offensive reason why framing the absence of climate policy is a good thing, which means we only need a 0.0001% risk of a net benefit in order to win the counterplay debate. I'll prove competition on the permutation, but the fact that they do not have a reason why, including why being a climate policy is necessary to solvency means the counterplay solves enough. Okay, they double drop the DOE scenario. The lane 500% doesn't say that economic collapse is inevitable. Lane just says that economic factors could hinder hegemonic dominance. That's a conceded economy DA to the F. The 1 in C evidence says that the DOE clean energy efforts are necessary to the economy because it's attracting brilliant minds from abroad, leads to entrepreneurship and innovation, which means that it solves all the reasons why structural decline is inevitable, but cutting DOE programs means that becomes impossible. Economic collapse, the terminal impact was conceded. The Kemp evidence talks about how the economic collapse caused a decline in international institutions, takes out all of the reasons why the status quo solves the major power war. They didn't answer that. The economy tanks those reasons now. Trump may be taking people's fingers off the button now, but in a world of economic decline, they've conceded that things like terrorism and rogue actors increase the propensity for miscalculation, which puts their finger right back on the button, causes nuclear escalation. Also conceded that nuclear winter causes extinction, which means that there's no difference between our impacts. Now, the conceding Glacier doesn't answer the readiness scenario. Glacier says the U.S. can increase domestic oil production to solve the Malaccan Strait closure. That doesn't answer the question of what the impact of oil dependency is on our military. You've conceded that refueling time is costly and hinders battlefield advancements from the military. It also tanks. It also allows tankers to be targeted for attack, which independently kills the readiness. Yes, the F causes massive cuts to DOE funding. The Trump administration is on the funding cut rampage, and the only thing saving the DOE now is that they aren't tied up in the larger climate debate. They've successfully distanced themselves because they've framed themselves around energy policy rather than climate policy. You've conceded that the F forces the DOE to adopt a stance on climate change, which triggers Republican backlash to the F. The two pieces of the 1 and Z evidence on this question are just too good. The fact that the affirmative changes the way that the renewable fuel standard operates means that it necessarily ties the Department of Energy into a climate change debate that they should not be a part of. Hegemony unsustainable doesn't answer our readiness good arguments. Lane doesn't say that the economic factors prevent our military from deploying to hotspot escalation, which is the impact in the 1 and C Spencer evidence. You've also conceded an indict of the Lane evidence. Their studies aren't reflexive and overvalue modern era problems without analyzing historical trends that disprove their unsustainability. Warrants also a blip in the 1 era, rejecting 2 era arguments again, drop the readiness key to solve hotspot escalation, road states, and terror is inevitable. Without the robust U.S. military, only readiness can prevent the escalation of those threats. The fact that they don't have a solvency deficit to the counterplan means that 10 people can die, and that net benefit still outweighs the nothing that they have now. The permutation debate miles extends due the after the process of the counterplan. This is incoherent and begs the question of the rest of the competition debate. It's the goddamn climate policy topic. In the fifth place, the Copeland panel doesn't have a single defense of the phrase climate policy. They deserve to lose this debate. A crucial framing argument that Miles does not come to grips with is that my reverse pit of doom was successful. Crossex conceded that they're a climate policy, and Crossex is binding. We agree that the F gets to define the words of the plan for fairness, but you define the F as climate policy, which means you have to defend the implications of that. The counterplan is not processually different from the affirmative. It's a functionally different policy. The Rotterneck is the only evidence in the debate that draws a distinction between climate and non-climate policies and said that climate policies are constituted by both a decrease in emissions and the motive for action on climate change. The counterplan does not use the frame of climate policy. They've conceded that their definition is necessary but not sufficient. Yes, climate policy includes a restriction on GHG emissions, but it also includes the motives and the justification for action. I'll explain my offense for that argument in a second. The first argument that he has about counterplan proliferation is just wrong. This is the only offense that the 1 era extends, which means I just have to beat this argument and you vote negative. Having a defensive climate policy solves every bad example of a counterplan that they offered. If you have climate leadership good arguments, then you beat the family values counterplan because there's no net benefit to that. We link turn the fringe affirmative argument. The counterplan is key to check those and forces teens to find defenses of climate policy. It means apps like the Clean Power Plan, public trust, modeling apps, precedent apps all have arguments. That's why framing the policy as a climate is key to solvency. Proves we force better topic debates, but we check these smaller industry apps that have nothing to do with climate change in general, like this one where they just promote biofuels. Now, we don't allow any word picks or rep case that conceded Jack's definition that we only get functional competition. We have that, and they didn't answer it. The Rotterdam evidence says that the way the policy is framed affects the way that it's carried out. It affects which constituencies get on board. It's necessary to things like elections and the politics disadvantages that are about the framing and justification of the policy to the public. Now, the non-falsifiability arguments about how you can't falsify the motive of policy is just proven wrong. They've conceded the Rotterdam 11 evidence about Japan that says that Japan was able to achieve emissions reductions before they instituted an official national climate policy, which means that people were able to historically delineate between climate and non-climate policies, even though they had the same effect of reducing emissions, which means that this is a distinction that's relevant to the literature. We have 4 cards, they have 1, which means we're just winning on this question. They've also conceded the Volgovici piece of evidence that says that climate policy changes the way that the EPA has to frame their policy. The EPA website proves that they're walking away from the framing of climate policy right now, but the app changes that. The Waldersick evidence also gives the empirical example of the EU and proves that climate policy tools are about the aim of the policy, not just the effect of the policy, which means that even if the counterplan results in similar restrictions that solve in the same way, the aim of the policy is what's necessary to having it be a climate policy in the first place. If they can win on the permutation of this counterplan, then they should lose the debate on topicality. Whether or not we use the framework of climate policy influences how others react in the the future, which proves our functional competition arguments, the type of policy plays on specific political contexts that alter the course of implementation. The Trump administration changed the game for climate policy. The Rotterdam evidence proves that we are functionally competitive, proves that the permutation can not solve these arguments. It's necessary for debate. The first is key to check for infirmities. I already explained this argument. Thousands of industry and pollutants of the weak ass that we all know the arbitrariness of substantiality. This forces the F not to run to run from the edges of the topic. At the end of the year, also checks mechanism explosion ensures that there is a stable source of offense to check against new affirmatives at the NDT. Defending climate leadership is not hard for the affirmative. Their only offensive reason as to why their view of competition is a good thing is because of different types of framing counterplans. We result in the best form of picks. This is the climate policy topic. Framing the policy rather than test the necessity of climate policy in the first place. Cross-X conceded that y'all wrote climate policy, which means the permutation is incoherent. You can't do a climate policy through the process of an energy policy. We have cards that just says they're functionally distinct thing.
Everyone good?
Yeah.
If we win the permutation, they didn't make a judge take argument, so the dissent stuff is fundamentally irrelevant. I will do some defense here just to cover my ass. The plan solves four spots, which destroys a water stance. You should prioritize our environment impacts. You always have to negotiate with military challengers and all with those of the environment that stress the biophysical limits of life. Their evidence says that the dollar crisis is inevitable. Will destroy the entire beast of U.S. power, which means the readiness of their expense evidence describes is impossible. They won't solve their internal like evidence. It's not oil dependence with the laser evidence and the 1 hour red defense to that. It said there is no chance of a long or prolonged allowed until we get reserves massing up super quick, which holds any sort of a price impact upon the DOD. Additionally, we have not read impact of that cost increase as any sort of material change on readiness or overall structure. Three is the only causal evidence about a budget cut is citing one single Heritage Foundation report that had a meeting with one Trump budget expert that recommended cutting this program. That is not any indication this will be the first thing on the chopping block or that anyone is seriously considering. The two in our framing that if 10 people die, that is enough of a net benefit is kind of
of telling because it amplifies all of the arguments I'm going to go for on the permutation that they cause an overinflation of trivial net benefits, like 10 people dying or a couple of people being impacted because of very small framing issues by virtue of this interpretation, which results in debates that always moot out the moot of the YIT. Now, permutation to the act through the process of the counterplan and permutation to the counterplan are both demonstrate this counterplan is fundamentally feasible. The permutation looks like we're doing the entirety of the act, which is restricting the biofuel sector and the emissions that it does. This is a land use restriction that R2AC Funk in evidence describing climate policy says is the core of that literature, which answers all of his so-called pit of doom stuff from cross-ex, because yes, we're a climate policy. We restrict the land use that is done, but you shouldn't get competition based on calling climate policy something else, because that is like putting lipstick on a pig, and it justifies a bunch of other terrible counterplans that absolutely ruin debate. He has no game on the examples of the one era where Miles was absolutely fantastic on. Here are a couple of things that are allowed under their interpretation. If you read their evidence saying climate policy and being distinguished from other policies is important, that could lead you to conclude that a counterplan that frames the app as a religious values policy would be popular under the Mike Pence agenda and the Trump administration. They can say that it is justified by religious doctrines about preserving the environment, etc., and then claim a bunch of advantage about international religious freedom, etc. They can say it's a business policy and talk about talking with the Chamber of Commerce and getting them on board with Trump. They can say literally anything. Hell, they could say that it is an Israel policy and read a small net benefit about appeasing them, the Israel lobby, and say that's an example of climate cooperation as a result of political mobilization of pro-Israel factions as well as the U.S. If there is a military advantage to any act, that could be the thin tie. And remember, the 2NR frame is they just need a very small net benefit for them to get in on this. So any of these seemingly preposterous counterplans are all justified if they can find a single card defending a fringe theory from any blog or any unqualified author, like this Rodimer card that they don't have qualifications listed for, which is what they have done in this debate. They have read one card distinguishing this, and then they've had the entirety of the 1NR and 2NR. This demonstrates that it causes substantive crowd out of any core debates. The second component of our argument isn't just that it creates they say that we were able to answer this with a climate diplomacy add-on. There were people don't say that using the word climate policy is what causes climate diplomacy. They say that the result of the climate policy is what results in this. Is the counterplan is the exact same result as the affirmative. That demonstrates this would not be a compelling answer. The second component of our argument is that they result in a world of debate that is much worse for the negative, because acts will not run to cornered areas of the topic like cap and trade or the carbon tax. They will actually run to small fringes and claim minor perception makes advantages upon a particular framing. Think of all the scary sector apps they talked about in the 2NR that they are functional limited, I guess, but then think about the model of apps that their counterintuitive interpretation causes the affirmative to have to focus all of their research on. It's minor perception advantage, having small lobbyists on board with the affirmative. It is ways that avoids every core negative generic and sidesteps crucial debates about a pressing issue of climate change that we should be discussing. The 2NR standard is functional competition, but the plan and the counterplan both fiat in the text the exact same restriction occurs to biofuels, which means that we are functionally indistinct. The only answer is this one piece of Rodner card that indicates that there is a distinction between climate and other forms of policy in terms of political lobbying, etc. They haven't quantified that or contextualized it to the context of the affirmative. This also doesn't make sense in a world of fiat, because they are fiating the exact same restrictions of the 1AC, and they haven't even told us what the differences between energy and climate policy would be. So even if you think this evidence is good in theory, it certainly does not make sense in the debate context. And even if you think that distinguishing climate from energy policy is something discussed in literature, an important discussion to have, that is not something that works in debate because of the strategic incentives it produces for fringe affirmatives as well as fringe negative strategies. The Japan highlighting makes literally no sense. It just says that Japan once had a climate policy and then they had an energy policy. The other part of their evidence that they've highlighted as intent to define just says for the purpose of this paper they are missing, which means that there is no sort of precision differential. And even if you do think their interpretation is a little bit more precise, it certainly is not as much of a robust model for quality debate about climate change as ours. Their last argument is about the EPA moving away from climate change right now. I don't know why that's a justification for any of their standards or having this as a debate. It's just a descriptive part about the status quo, their last argument.
Yeah, I think they're in a rough spot.
The only argument they can go for against our thing is just like, we have to claim advantages about climate policy in the plan text. Think about the awful perception advantages that that would be as the only sort of the topic. Their only recourse to this type of counterplan is the app is locked into just climate diplomacy, which locks in GFU as the model of the NDT, and also causes the app, when they have to innovate, to run to squirrely shit that's worse.
Can both teams create a finalized app and can you include the plan, kind of plan text and send out?
The disapp stuff for.
can be a hard sell anyway on picking out of motives, but so the 2NR big problem is it's extremely defensive. There's not like one clear offensive thing that you've picked or flipped the side of literature versus debatability at any point that you have some clear offense that you've then done D to all their examples of terrible counterplan. So I conclude the counterplan is bad. They've got a list of examples. Like, for example, the business policy commerce thing made some sense to me. That leads to trivial political calculation net benefits. The other thing that I was convinced by in the end that I would have liked to be a bigger part of the 2NR was the response to the advantage area that you think they have to defend is like staleness from GSU kind of thing. I think that would have been better to be a lot more. So the problems with the neg is like, so there's no definitional comparison at any point in this debate. You're just like, yeah, it needs to be about GHGs, but we'd also like it to include motives. There's no real reason aside from access to your net benefit. There's no real defense of why political consequences are the most important thing we need to be concerned about when evaluating these sorts of policies. Maybe normal means is this is how climate policy needs to be interpreted, and you've got some theoretical arguments why competing off normal means is good. And I'm also just unclear at the end what the absent your description and even the card that describes the functional difference. I know that people in Congress may not like when, or they may be turned off when climate change is mentioned, but I don't know what an energy policy version of this is. So even just like a description of the distinction between the two is a little bit unclear to me at the end. For the AF, so it's a little bit unorganized, the 2AR, especially distinguishing between why the counterplan is bad and the competitiveness of the counterplan. So if those two are kind of bracketed off and organized a little bit better. Similarly for you, that they don't have a real good defense of like why we need to pick out to determine the functional difference of political consequences. It would have been nice if you had the reverse of that, why it's pretty shitty to just pick out to determine the political distinction between the two of these things. That is probably a good interlink to substantive crowd out, for example. And like I already said earlier, this advantage area they want to confine you to, that staleness education impact, I think is pretty good as well, to play defense to all of our literature offense. Debatability, I think, was pretty good for the 2AR. That's what I got.
So, fundamentally, I think that the strategy would be at its best if the affirmative had said or somehow used climate policy. I think it is, when you really, you kind of tried to frame it as something a little bit differently, but when you really thought about how the Warrens lined up, it really was a language or framing pick at some level of the notion of climate policy and then an attempt to use a variety of mechanisms to kind of pin them or force them to defend that. As just an academic aside for both teams, the entire question of what affirmatives can and can't sever out of, and like a whole discussion of that word, I think might be something you would want to talk about more for both sides if you like ran it back. But when I thought about it, through the lens of textual competition, that's tough because I don't know that they use this text in the way that the counterplan text is written is by definition like plan plus. The functional arguments are a little tricky because I kind of agree with the affirm's characterization that the function of the two is identical. So I kind of thought a little bit harder about your argument and what Wake was kind of trying to get me to latch onto. And I think it was that they're obliged to defend certain framing on the basis of cross-examination burdens, topicality burdens, or just like a better model of debate. And I ultimately think that those three things that sort of would be affirmative would be forced to defend for different reasons. I didn't vote on any of them. I want to start by saying that the T portion of it was a little bit undeveloped. Like a lot of your arguments were, and then they're not T. But when I kind of looked at the definitions that both sides ran, it would be, I think, very hard for a typical panelist to tell Cal you're not topical. You know what I mean? Based on the definitions that were read, kind of everyone agreed that a climate policy is a GHG reduction scheme. You're right, your card goes a step further and draws a distinction between climate and non-climate policies, but I was sort of left wanting as to
why they were not, you know, a climate policy under the terms of the warrant that your own sort of evidence and that their evidence provides. I mean, at no point were they not a GHG reduction. Does that make sense? They didn't have a greenhouse classic climate advantage, you know what I mean? But I didn't think that that was flushed out enough, nor was the question, like, and I actually fault both sides for this, of whether or not perms have topicality burdens. That wasn't really fleshed out. I think there's a real debate to be had that, like, almost every permutation that gets run in most instances is either not topical or overwhelmingly extra topical. So I thought that that just needed more discussion. That was sort of left as a kind of a an impact that I think that the negative thought was more powerfully large than maybe an impact. In terms of the cross-ex threads, I sort of share the app's characterizations that the cross-examination did not go as decisively neg as the neg would hope. Did you ask them if they were a climate policy? Yes, but in every way that an affirmative tiptoes and says, we're topical, but we don't necessarily know what you mean by that. I think that the affirmative, in fact, both affirmatives in the opening cross-examination were really pretty clear to kind of jump in on that. So I thought your strongest argument was just that, like, debate would be better if they had to defend this. And I think that really because your evidence lines up as a framing counterplan, you were kind of right and kind of wrong. Like, you were correct that the affirmative could nullify a lot of bad examples by having, like, a strong framing advantage. But as, like, a broader model, they were kind of correct that that would bring in a lot of debates that would move us away from central or more central questions on the topic. And I didn't really logically understand how you could win the argument that a framing advantage would not kind of legitimize a kind of broader set of debates that would be kind of offshoots that would, you know, run away from the center of the topic and run towards some of the examples that they provided or just towards, like, Rep's case, basically. And so I didn't think that the model that you're sort of advancing was as narrow as you hoped it would be, and therefore I kind of concluded that you weren't ahead on the T and cross-ex warrants, and that the model that's kind of being discussed is not decisively a stronger model writ large for the community.
I don't have a ton to add. I think that last piece particularly about just, like, I think that you're probably correct that the actor win, like, some of these debates by reading, like, a climate diplomacy add-on. I don't really think those debates would be good or productive. I think whatever substance is crowded out would likely be more interesting and engaging. And then the other piece of offense I just found persuasive was a proliferation of counterplans with kind of framing up benefits. It just seems like your pushback on some of these arguments is, like, we don't allow floating pick because we're functionally competitive, which I think just sort of goes back to some of the T problems where, like, you ask them, are you a climate policy? And they sort of say without saying yes. But that just sort of, it's like, I'm not really sure why the negative needs to be able to say your app is spun as climate policy in order for debate to be good. And absent that, it's just, like, very difficult to persuade me of anything else.
Questions for any students?
That all makes sense to us. I have actually one super quick question, unless you all have anything that Kyle, you said that the perm stuff could have been more organized between, like, the definitions and the theory stuff. Kind of like, how would you envision, or how could we make a reason to prefer our definitions outside of theory?
Well, I do think they have to be in tandem. I just thought it was a little bit not at the end of the debate substantively, but sloppy organizationally.
Oh, yeah.
Between the two of them is the only thing. So
okay.
It's like, I can't see a way just deciding it's not competitive outside of the counterplan being bad. I'm not sure if there, you know, is a way to disconnect the two of those, but, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
you
probably should have just done, like, our interp and bottom of the two hours, like, card by card on their stuff and move that up to the top. Yeah.
Okay,
cool. I just misunderstood.
Yeah, that's just what I meant.
Yeah.
Okay,
that makes sense.
All right. Good luck to everyone.
Good luck.
Good
luck.
Thank you.
All right,
we should just go.
Okay,
cool. I'm going to stay here.
Okay. I'm about to set up a
That's
what debate is this?
MSU versus Arizona State.